How to Gunnery, the Art of Good Shooting, in War Thunder Air Realistic Battle. What defines good gunnery? Since War Thunder does the best it can to mimic reality, while still remaining an economically viable source of entertainment, we can look back on history. The first thing that jumps out from combat reports is the willingness to get close. So you cannot miss. This utterly insane combat report, made by Robert Little of 8th Squadron Royal Naval Air Service, in 1917 is a good data point. It is important to remember that Little was flying in a Sopwith triplane, with 110 horsepower to its name. It was made out of wood and doped canvas. Also, he was flying without a parachute. Let me repeat, no parachute. The narrative from the combat report.
At 7:30 a.m., I observed a formation of 8 Albatross scouts, attacking a formation of DH-4s. I dived on the nearest hostile scout, when I was fired upon from behind. I turned sharply and got under his tail, and fired about 50 rounds, at a range of about 10 to 15 yards. The hostile aircraft came so near I had to take my eyes off the sight to avoid colliding. The hostile aircraft turned over on its side and then nosedived. I was unable to watch it any further, as my engine stopped at this moment. I glided west and was attacked by 4 hostile scouts. I dived toward our lines, and, when over our side, spun down. I got my engine going at about 500 feet, and climbed back, but the hostile aircraft had gone. Lieutenant Southern of 25 Squadron RFC confirmed that the hostile aircraft I fired on went down out of control.
In World War I, too close was that you had to take your eye off the gun sight, for fear of hitting your opponent. Wait. Stop the game. Did the player's bullets just pass through the opponent's plane without hitting? How close is too close in War Thunder? For that we have to understand how modern games work. The first rule of online gaming is that you cannot trust the client. As a result, the server is the source of truth. Yes, God is single-threaded, and reality is a tick function with 3,000 if statements, 900 for loops, 2 million lines of code that has never seen a unit test, and at least 10 functions that have never been executed. The connection between a client and a server is constrained by the speed of light. Unless Telstra is your internet provider, then the speed of mud determines your ping. For players in North America, the connection to the War Thunder servers is around 70 milliseconds. Without lag, packet loss, or hiccups in tick speed, this means it takes 140 milliseconds for an input to travel from one client to another, and 280 milliseconds for a round trip. Games get around this by simulating the state of the world on the client, with the server being the source of truth. If the simulation on the client gets too far out of sync with the server, then the client will do a replay to bring the simulation back in line with the server. The important point is, you are shooting at where the client-side simulation thinks your opponent will be, not where they are. This is fine for fat-ass blue water vehicles and slow-ass tanks, but planes can move quickly in 3 dimensions. If a plane is flying in a straight line, the simulation is accurate, but when a plane is jinking around and changing velocity, the closer you get to your opponent, the higher the probability you are shooting at a ghost. When is close too close in War Thunder? It depends on your ping and the defensive maneuvers your opponent is doing. The US Navy pilots were the Allied elite in 1942. They practiced teamwork and gunnery in peacetime. Even though there was only enough ammunition for 9 rounds in one machine gun, they still practiced. When the Wildcat with 650 caliber machine guns was introduced, John Thatch commented, "Increased firepower is not a substitute for marksmanship. The pilot who will miss with 4 won't be able to hit with 8. In 1944, Navy and Marine pilots relied on their marksmanship when facing inexperienced Japanese pilots and fragile aircraft. In a battle over Okinawa, Jeff Doro of the Death Rattlers commented, "I could see it was going to be a long day, so I switched off 2 of my guns." Due to his marksmanship and conservation of ammunition, he shot down 6 aircraft during the engagement with his F-4U Corsair. Wait, stop the game? Did those machine guns just cross the streams? The Ghostbusters told us, don't cross the streams. Next, we need to understand how machine guns work with aircraft. Let's look at this from the Junkers Ju-88 point of view. The Corsair is 750 meters away from the Junkers, and firing with 650 caliber machine guns. The player has his guns harmonized to 600 meters, using the game's gun distance setting. This means at 600 meters all 6 of the guns will be in a close pattern, but will diverge afterwards. Like so. The convergence diagram has pretty straight lines, but due to dispersion, reality is much messier. Bullets operate under the laws of quantum mechanics. When you observe a bullet, it collapses into a wave function. Wait, this is not correct. When you observe a bullet, it behaves like a particle from the Matrix, which Neo is able to dodge in slow motion. Wait, this is not correct either. Due to dispersion, a bullet's location and a firing pattern is best thought of probabilistically. Yes, that is better. Firing a machine gun at a target is a non-deterministic action. In the game, this means you want to aim the pattern of fire onto the hitbox of the opponent's aircraft. This maximizes the probability of a bullet colliding with a hitbox. For example, if the circle of a firing pattern collides with a player's hitbox, there's a probability of a bullet being in that location. Let's say for argument, a 50% chance. A bullet is there or not. Dodge Schrodinger's cat Neo. In a 50 caliber ground belt, there is a 75% chance the round is armor-piercing, and a 25% chance that it is also an incendiary. This gives a probability of 0.08 that the bullet colliding with the hitbox is an armored incendiary round. That is a low probability, and also why you should send plenty of rounds downrange to maximize the likelihood of a hitbox collision with a machine gun's pattern. The worst gun for dispersion in the game is the non-upgraded 45mm cannon on the Yak-9. The cannon is mounted in the propeller shaft, which is a pretty rigid support. Wait, stop the game, this is not dispersion. It is just Splatter City.
Россия идет расстрелять. Банк, банк. Банк, банк, банк. Пожарный бой.
Indeed, Tatiana, indeed. Next we need to understand the impact of gravity between objects with mass. The Earth weighs a lot in comparison to a bullet, human or aircraft. So much more so, that acceleration of an object toward the Earth is consistently about 9.8 meters per second. Fighting that downward force is the speed of the aircraft, plus the muzzle velocity of the gun. For a 50 caliber machine gun, muzzle velocity is 890 meters per second. For the mixed armament on a Spitfire, the Hispano is 840 meters per second, and the Browning 853 meters per second. Note that the muzzle velocity of a Hispano and Browning are similar, so that they can be fired together in a consistent pattern. Most machine guns that were mounted in aircraft are between 850 and 900 meters per second, muzzle velocity. The cannons though, oh boy. The later German MG-151 cannon has a muzzle velocity of 850 meters per second, the Russian Shvac cannon, 750 meters per second, the Japanese Type 99 cannon, a muzzle velocity of 600 meters per second, and the winner for worst aircraft mounted cannon goes to the Japanese 40mm cannon, with a muzzle velocity of 245 meters per second. Wait, stop the game. If those cannon rounds were traveling any slower, they would be falling backwards. The game has a vertical targeting toggle, which turns this sad-looking shell drop into this equally sad-looking shell drop. Using vertical targeting is personal preference, and probably not necessary in the third-person view of air realistic battle. However, if you are having trouble getting high-velocity machine guns and low-velocity cannon to fall in a pattern, it can be useful. Why did air forces use slow-firing big cannons with low muzzle velocity? Early Cold War Soviet doctrine was, if a round hit an opposing aircraft, then it p-hole dandruff better well go down. The MiG-15 had a 37mm cannon and two 23mm cannons for such big boomstick action. Next we need to learn deflection shooting, or leading the target. This is where you aim the firing pattern at where your opponent's aircraft will be when the bullets arrive. When Clive Caldwell completed his first 30 sorties with 250 Squadron in North Africa, he lamented that he had fired at aircraft, missed, and, instead had collected damage from opposing aircraft. One evening when his flight was returning from a mission, he noticed the shadows of their aircraft on the desert. He decided to have a shot at a shadow. He later wrote, "I suddenly realized the significance of these shadows racing across the sand. When I tried to shoot a shadow, I missed. I was way over and behind." This was an immediate demonstration by contact registration of self-correcting the method of learning deflection shooting. Caldwell wrote a treatise on shadow shooting which was shared through the Desert Air Force. Shadow shooting later became a part of training in Australia as well, though it was done on water, rather than desert. Caldwell put his shadow shooting into practice on December 5, 1941, when 112 Squadron attacked a formation of Stukas. In the space of a few minutes, Caldwell had shot down five Stukas. On February 20, 1942, Butch O'Hare broke up an attack by Betty's on the USS Lexington alone. In four passes he shot down five aircraft. During the Marianas turkey shoot, Dave McCampbell in his Hellcat shot down seven aircraft in two flights, including five duties in his first sortie. This was a pattern with aces. When an aircraft was near them, they made their gunnery count. They did not miss. In summary, how should you shoot in War Thunder? 1. Get close. 2. Know how online multiplayer games work. 3. Know your weapons. 4. Lead your target. Now, take the LOL city with your Lamal planes and kill the newbies. Please, K, thanks, bye.